It definitely played a role to accelerate our decision to expand into North America. We always thought that we would want to do it at some point. And at the beginning of last year, we really decided that this needed to happen faster. And Canada understood very well that if they wanted to keep a place in this race, and batteries will play an instrumental cornerstone role in this energy transition economy, if they want to play a role there, they needed to match or to set into place mechanism that were close or similar to the Inflation Reduction Act. So I would say it has been a catalyst rather than the reason per se.
So just to sum it up, there's several reasons you found the right skills, the right energy supply, and also you're making use of this funding to open this factory in Canada. So all of this came together. I would like to also double check whether you have any further plans for expansion in the United States or Canada for that matter.
Okay, one step at a time. Let's build Canada first. It's going a project for which the phase one will deliver the first cells in mid-26. We will be fully built by 28, 29. So this is a very big endeavor. It's a $9 billion US investment once fully built at 60 gigawatt hour. So we need to build this. On the other hand, you're absolutely right to point out that a lot of the market is in the United States as well. And there is plenty of space and plenty of customers there for expansion. We also have a company we acquired a couple of years ago in California, which is on more advanced technologies. It's called Cuberg, is lithium metal, focusing more on the aviation industry. And we will probably have Cuberg scaling up capacity before we open a second very large plant in North America for cells.
Hi, I'm Giovanna Bersecci, and thank you for watching. You can check out more of our videos by clicking on the boxes on the screen. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more from CNBC International. Thank you for watching.